The Inner Bank STEM Center is getting a $49,000 technology grant from the Cannon Foundation. That's an organization founded by one of North Carolina's historic textile barons.
Now to your site's Ariana Kraft shows us how the center will use the money to prepare teenagers for future industries.
Operators of Beaufort County's Inner Bank STEM Center are always looking for ways to improve their educational offerings. Well, now a new project is in the works, a digital fabrication classroom, also known as a fab lab.
Today we have more than 2,000 fab labs around the world in more than 100 and some countries.
The fab lab movement started at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology.
The idea became that we need to take it to a younger audience because there is not enough kids are with an interest in the STEM.
One of those labs will find an audience at the Inner Bank STEM Center.
So we wanted to design an exciting, engaging, and hands-on project-based program for these students to help jumpstart their enthusiasm when they do go back to the in-person school scenario.
The Fab Lab will have 3D printers and other advanced fabrication tech.
What these labs have enable the students to and the teacher to work on is to bring these knowledge into actual physical possibility in their own classroom or in their own space.
The STEM Center works with at-risk kids from underrepresented communities
who are already struggling in the science and technology arenas, have lost even more as a result of this COVID-19 impact.
Leaders say this will make the STEM Center a place where teens are prepared for high-tech careers.
A lot of boat industries are situating themselves in Beaufort County. Hopefully some more technology-based industries will be situating themselves here, and they're going to be looking for a workforce.
STEM Center operators tell me they're proud to be the state's first small nonprofit group to get a fab lab. In Washington, Ariana Kraft, 9 on your side.